Hello, everybody! Welcome back to another episode of Not Too Minecraft. I believe this is episode 57, if I'm not mistaken. I could be one or two episodes off. Today we have some technical building things to do. Not too technical, but just a couple little things we need to build around the place that we've been delaying for quite some time. One of them I didn't really think of building until just recently. And the other one's kind of been something that I wanted to build for quite a while, that I think will both be... Well, I know one of them will be very beneficial to us, and the other one will just save us a lot of time between transporting. Right now, I'm just kind of giving my cows a little bit of loving so they can grow up, and I can grab some delicious food off of them soon. We're not building an auto cow farm soon. Well, we're going to be building one soon, but we're not building one right now. We will definitely soon, but yeah, those are definitely pretty useful, and I've used the word definitely, I think, 3 times in the recording already. That's 4 now, so we're off to a very good start. The first thing that we're going to be building today is one of those auto, or not an auto thing, but one of those horse tester things that Tyler built out by, kind of, I guess, more like the random build field in HTM, where it's kind of near the spawn and by the center toward the Salty Lagoon. So we're going to be building one of those right on that little area right there. Because I figure I'm going to do, like, selective horse breeding soon and things. And we got to make it all look good. But before I get into that, QSAD lighting. It was a very hard day for us yesterday. Hold my hand, Kara. We lost a valiant friend to our humble mountainside estate. Or our, pizzeria, heh. This is not the bunny that we once knew and loved. Over here, this was our first bunny that we had, Mr. Overwatch Bunny, who died by falling off because we did not encase him properly. And this is the Fountain Bunny, who suffocated inside of a roof. Kara was playing on my account, however, the death was not her fault whatsoever. This little bunny happened to have gone in this area right here. In fact, we're going to need to patch this up because these crops cannot grow. And this is not the Fountain Bunny, not the Overwatch Bunny. We have yet to name this one. We'll probably call him the Suffocation Bunny. I don't know. That's a terrible name. But basically, Kara had a carrot in her hand and walked through here. I shit you not. She put she had the carrot in her hand. The bunny phased through this wall and just splattered down and died. I believe he took suffocation damage when he fell through the wall, and then the actual height falling probably killed him. But he literally just phased through this block right here. It makes about as much sense as Allie joining into the game twice. So, maybe the bunny was not meant to be, and maybe just unfortunate circumstances really do happen, but we have yet to name this one. However, after today, since we'll also be building an auto fish farm, we'll have some name tags and name this one whatever it's so desired. In fact, actually, if you guys would like to leave some suggestions for a name for the bunny above, or what we could name tag him once we get a name tag, down in the description, comments. That would be very much appreciated, and maybe we could actually do a community name bunny this time. I know, you can't... Why do you leave twice? Just leave once! We get it, you're going! Anyway, so things that we're going to need to actually build this thing is a redstone repeater, a pressure plate, a couple pieces of redstone, and also an Enderman came by and dropped off this tasty little gift for us, so we're going to leave this here for probably about half an episode before I decide to actually break the thing. And we're going to need some fences, as well as some blocks and a lot of freaking signs. We don't need too many signs, honestly, since the one that Tyler made, we're going to be pretty much replicating Tyler's. Let's see how many signs this will make. That's 9 signs in total. We don't really need anything less than, or anything more than 9, so we don't really need to label like 1, 2, 3, or 4, since I don't think any horses are physically can be that slow. We're going to need some blocks. I'm thinking dark oak wood. Spruce wood might look nice, and we can put some slabs up on top. We'll need some redstone as well. That should be way more than enough, and we're gonna need a redstone repeater. Methinks we only need one, and I am correct, So, the only thing we actually do need, apart from this right now, we can get rid of some other junk right now, just toss it in here. The buckets go over here, with the water in there, and the golden boots, honestly, we can just... Oh! I should also show you guys before we get started on this as well, that Kara also messed around with a couple things in my house and made things look pretty beautiful. In the spot where we had the destroyed chests, which I'm gonna have to put some chests here eventually, but for right now, it is a trash can. So we have a little cactus underneath there with some sand surrounding it, which looks very, very nice. We can throw out our golden boots. We can throw out our power one bow. We can throw out our iron pick, which we really don't need. And we can throw out the rest of the 2 wheat. Apart from that, it's a really nice addition. I really like it. And she also did this way down here. Now, for those that don't recall, quite a few episodes back, I completed a little... second floor, like a lower ground floor for the casino to house the different slot machines that I had going, kind of like the gambling machine where it's not, you know, like a dealer done thing. She actually decorated this whole place down here, and I think it looks absolutely beautiful. Now, I probably will in the future be extending this to where this gets removed and we make like different lanes, like you can go down there. You can go down here for some more junk, but right now, this looks absolutely beautiful. And I must say, Kara has a very, very great design for complementing the room and making it look like it's a really nice, clean, and friendly atmosphere while also relaxing you as well, because the blue carpeting is very relaxing, true. And that's actually one of the reasons that a lot of casinos have blue carpeting. A lot of casinos have red carpeting is to keep you more awake and on your toes, at least from what I think I've read. Blue is more of a calming thing. In fact, actually, I'm going to stop talking because I don't really know all that all the way. But anyway, it looks nice apart from that. But she has a very good artistic design when it comes to interior decorating, as well as exterior. She's a very good builder and probably a better Minecraft player overall than I am. But yeah, for those that are curious on how it works, we don't have a pick. Let's go up and actually get our silk touch pick out of the ender chest that's up top here. I believe the ender chest is still in the corner there. Couple bunnies that actually escaped from our little pen. That's why you kind of saw a little bunny kind of walking around there. He's a rather cute little bunny. Is he over there? Where's the little bunny? Oh, there he is. He's so cute. Just right in the middle of the pants. Okay, Allie's actually joining and leaving at the right duration now. That's good. Okay, but basically what you do is you'll grab a little golden ingot like this. And we'll put this back for right now just so you guys can see. And you'll throw a gold ingot in here. And once you do that, these actually got filled from the building. I guess Kara might have dumped those in there. So you throw a gold ingot in, and this will basically keep spinning around for quite a little while. There's some redstone all behind here, a frick ton of redstone. If you'd like, you can go to the video where I actually made the gambling machine. It should be pretty clear which one it is by the thumbnails and stuff. It was a two-parter. Might have been a three-parter, I'm not sure. But basically, once an item falls in the back, it'll stop, and we lost. It's a 1 in 5 chance, pretty much, and that's gotten on that 3 times in a row. And if you hit the gold, then you'll get 3 gold ingots flying out of there. I may change what actually dispenses out of there, like maybe a gold block or something of a bit higher value. But yeah, that's how it works. I think it's pretty nice. So in the meantime, let's go ahead and get started on building this little area. First, we need to actually excavate. The whole thing needs to be about 15 blocks in length. So I'm figuring if we make it right here, this is probably like the flattest area that I've got that still stays within the bounds of the actual building, I should say. So let's see here. I got the dirt in our inventory, and we also... Oh, this is our fortune! I wanted our silk touch! Freaking heck, now I don't have grass to actually make this thing look nice. Oh well, we'll probably be making it out of like a wood floor or something anyway, so let's just go ahead and encase this whole area up here. And we'll get building on the actual contraption and then we'll decorate it for later on. Probably gonna need to light this area up though. Okay. So this will definitely save us a lot of time and be a lot more friendly when it comes to actually testing our horses and trying to find the ultimate horse. Or create the ultimate horse, I should say. We had pretty much the ultimate horse quite a while ago, but sadly he is no longer around since he suffocated mysteriously. I really don't know how, but yeah, was quite sad, quite unfortunate. So I think right around here should be good in terms of design. Alright, yeah, that seems to be pretty good. Alright, so the actual thing will need to be about 15 blocks in length, and we're going to need a repeater, we're going to need the redstone signal here, so I think we should just go ahead and get started with it. We got our stone pressure plate, and it'll be going in this direction right here. So I think the first thing we need to do is actually figure out what is 15 blocks in length. So if we were to do, I'm thinking maybe the spruce wood across like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, yeah, 15 blocks. This seems pretty good. Now, is this the length that we want to do it? Because I think, no, we're going to actually push it out to right about here. Because we're also going to do the little jumping area as well. So let's do it. So it's right here. Oh, that's not going to work because it's on the grass. Break the grass first. Perfect. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, we got 15 in our inventory. Should be good enough to test with. Perfect. Now, the way it'll work is you put the repeater smack dab right in front of it with a 3-tick delay to right there. And you'll put the pressure plate on the side right about here. And the two redstone will hook to the side right there. And then this will be a 15 signal strength, so we don't need any repeaters or anything on the actual arena itself. And I think I'm going to do something like this, where I put the stone slabs above right here, because I think this looks really good, really sleek, really dark. Looks definitely very nice. And you look very nice, Mr. Zombie, that is for sure. I need to make sure and check my mic wasn't muted. That would have been a tragedy. I've had that. I may have lost a recording from it being muted the entire time and not realizing till the day after when I was going to post it. So, yeah, that wasn't really the brightest of things. So let's go ahead and I think the numbers should be maybe right like, thinking lower like this. Style the signs a little bit so we can do like that. 15. Yeah, I think that looks good. So this would be 14. We actually haven't made the fence gates either yet. Looks a little bit weird since there's nothing on top there, but honestly you can't really do it any more of an even way. So let's do like that. 12. 11. 10. And then we'll just use the rest of the three signs that we have here. 9. I don't think any horses should be slower than this. And if they're slower than 7, which I don't believe is possible, you need to find yourself a new horse because he's not even fit out for testing. Alright, so 7 should be the minimum speed to which any horse should actually go with. So the next thing that we'll do is we'll actually lay down the pathway right here. So we can do... No, we don't actually have any food on us. Well, we do have 2 cooked pork chop. When did we get these? Did we kill some pigs earlier? Must have killed a pig or something. And then we can put the dark oak wood. I'm kind of trailing along a zombie right here. Hi, little zombie. Okay, that looks good. And what we can do next is line up the redstone. Oh, we already have the redstone right there. We're actually going to need to make the fence gates, which I believe we have enough wood for. We're going to need about 15 of those. Hi, little bunny. Oh, I think the bunny wants to gamble. Bunny, do you want to gamble? Oh, is he trying to go? Oh, he wants to be the dealer. All right. Spin me up. I'm going to give you, I'm going to give you 1 golden carrot. I want... 3 on the triple. Can you give me a... Oh, no, you want to go for double? Can you give me some on the double, Mr. Bunny? Mr. Bunny! Can you give me some on the double? Yes, my bed is right underneath there. Can you go ahead and take that out for me, please? Mr. Bunny? Yes, hello. Oh, do you want to go back to the triple? Oh, no, not really. I don't really like the way he's operating this casino right now. Oh, he's letting me get killed. Well, thank you, Mr. Bunny. I'll leave this little iron that I just so happened to find on the ground for you. It was a great, very, very great business that you got going on here. It was very dandy, and I think we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna leave you be. We're actually gonna block you up because I want to keep you in here, Mr. Bunny. I don't like the way you operate this casino, so you're gonna stay in here forever. Okay? Okay, sounds very good. He's gonna be my little casino bunny for the good while. Yeah, I don't like the way bunnies operate casinos, and I actually needed to go back in here to get inside the, what's it called? Crafting table. Okay, here we go. So we're gonna need 15 fence gates. So I think we're gonna need with this a bunch of sticks, and the wood will be separated in the middle, I believe. I think that's how fence gates work. So 16, this should be 16. Yeah, dark oak fence gates. We only need 15. In fact, actually, I think we only need 14, since you don't put the first one down, otherwise it will hinder the performance. He's our little casino bunny. I kind of like him. He has a good styling, because it's like white and black, so it has kind of like the white glass and... Yes, hello, Mr. Bunny. You know what? He's the fancy pants bunny. I wish bunnies could wear pants. Imagine you could put like leather pants on bunnies, make them look all cute.
Animal abuse.
I'm just making him look better. Okay, so we have fence gates and we put them down like this. So for those that don't know how this works, or maybe it's your first time seeing it, basically, when the pressure plate is activated, all these are shut. When the pressure plate is activated, this will open up all of the... Is this one?
You put it 16.
Did I put 16? 1, 2... Oh, you know what I did there? Because I forgot to remove this one because I was just using this as a barrier. Thank you. See, this is why I should always have Kara next to me whenever I'm doing these builds, because she's always like, no, you did this wrong, you dunce. And I'm always like, yeah, I did. Where'd the pressure plate go? Did I break the pressure plate? Oh, it... I broke that, didn't I?
You lagged.
Okay, the tale of the mysterious... Ooh, and there was a cave noise there. Oh, that's spooky. Okay, I am terrified out of my socks. So you want to remove this one right here. Basically, how it'll work is you'll get your horse, and this will activate all the fences, and you basically run across it, and whatever your horse gets stuck on, that is the horse's speed. So for example, we're actually going to go over and take our speed horses to make sure this actually works properly, and if I'm correct, it should. Because I pretty much replicated exactly what Tyler did, and if I somehow mess this up, then I've got some issues here with... Alright. Break that off and make sure this horse testing area works. I think this looks really nice. That's a really nice spot for the horse testing area. Okay. Go on here, and then you'll run across the platform, and... What? A 2 speed? Really now? Or a 14 speed? Oh no, I kind of got caught on there. This is not a 14 speed horse. Hold on. 14 speed is what this seems to be getting stuck on. Oh, you know what? No. I think I did it wrong. Hold on, because this is supposed to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Unless I'm...
Go test it at logs.
Yeah, I'm thinking... Because the last time I tested this horse... Oh, that's weird. Hold on. So this is a 13. Oh, I might have been because I just got a curve off on it. Is he actually... Oh, there's a little bit of lag there. Is this actually a 14-speed horse? Oh, it's between 13 and 14 here. Hold on, I'm actually going to go test this at logs area because I'm thinking, if this is actually a 14-speed horse, this will be the first 14-speed horse I've ever actually tried on the server, and it makes me think how many other horses that may have also been 14s if I've tested them as well. I find it funny that I make this so I don't have to go out and travel to logs area, to logs build anymore, and yet here I am going to... check out Log's build, so that's just fantastic. I wish there was an easier way to get through this, like I wish you could take your horse through the crossroads that Shoko made. Although I think he said that he tried doing that in the horse race. I never actually looked at his perspective on that, but honestly, I want to go back and check that out, because that sounds hilarious.
Well, his horse died, so I doubt you want to go through that way.
Well, no, I definitely do not want to do that, but I think it would be funny just to see how his horse actually died from that, and how he actually... I don't know if he actually got it into the crossroads or not, or just wound up. Because how would you do that? How do you airlift a horse up ladders? I've also yet to find a killer bunny on the server as well. Oh, I can't wait for Vic and Lachlan to come back so they can see that prank and react to it. If they haven't already seen... Yeah, honestly, I'd be pretty pissed. The slime one was fun. They both loved that out of their butts. Preston's door trap, kind of a nuisance, but a little bit funny. Logs has definitely got some creative style to it, and I give him 20,000 points for effort. That took him, I think, like 7 hours to actually wind up completing, getting all the materials and building it, but... Holy crap. That's gonna take a freaking long time to excavate, and that I don't know. Curious to see what the reactions are gonna be on that. So we have this area right here. No, it says on here that it's a 13 speed. I wonder if it's the tick delay that I have right on here. No, this one is a repeater that's set to a 3-tick delay with 1-2 redstone off. And that's showing that's a 13 speed. Now, well, that got lagged a little bit, but yet on mine... That is bizarre. It's got the same exact styling as before. Got the redstone down right there.
Check where the pressure plate is on yours.
Well, the pressure plate on mine is...
3 away?
Yeah, it's got the 2 redstone right there and the repeater that's set on the 3 tick, on the 3rd tick right here. I'm looking at a screenshot of logs as well because I was using that for a reference. So on here, it's a solid 13. On mine... It was a 13 and a 14. I might be missing something. Kara, am I missing anything? Are you catching up on this? Because I'm pretty confused. I'm sure there's going to be one very smart person in the comments to be like, well, I think this is your issue here, and you need to change this about it. But for right now, I am definitely confused, and I didn't really think there was going to be any troubleshooting on this at all. So I guess we'll go back and we'll check it just to make sure that all's correct. But... From what I looked at, it should be entirely similar. What it might be is it might be the different entities and stuff around the area might be causing actually a little bit of lag. Because in my area, it does seem a bit smoother than over by that area. So for all we know, my area could be better for horse testing than where Tyler built his. Which is not Tyler's fault. It's more just, you know, it's a very... populated and busy area. So we got our horse testing area over there. 2 off like that, 2 redstone, and the pressure plate was hooked up straight to the left of it, and it was on a 3-tick delay. At least I believe. Yeah, look at this. 2 right there, and a 3-tick delay, and these were all removed just to test the speed. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I thought for a second I miscounted or something, and I would have just hit my head so hard. So we do this again, and we just speed forward. Yeah, he gets caught at the 14. And you know what's funny? He actually seems a bit faster on this for some reason. 13 speed.
Maybe he has more momentum there at your place?
I don't think momentum...
Like, do it really close to the pressure plate and start.
Do it really close to the pressure plate. I don't think momentum actually carries anything in terms of horse speed. I think there's that initial start, but I think that's only like half of a block or something. Because you catch up to speed pretty much instantly.
So you keep getting... And go back further?
Oh, I need to do it in a straightforward line. So right about...
Yeah, and go back really far now.
Go back really far. Got the angle. Straightforward. That is definitely a mystery. Although this horse, I guess we'll have to label it.
See?
Weird. You can't lag to the point where... Well, I guess lagging would make you go less fast, so maybe we are lagging here. I don't know. But just for safe reasons, I'm going to call this horse a 14 speed, just to make myself feel better. So yeah, we have a speed 14 horse... That is definitely weird. So anyway, the last part that we have to do for the actual horse testing area is just do the tiny little jump area. And we'll see how long this episode stretched on for. I'll probably do the... I might, depending on how long this has been, do the auto fish farm in the next episode and just kind of perfect this little area right now. We're gonna need a lot of wood. We're gonna need a lot of freaking wood. We've got a ton of wood right... Oh, we've got a tons of wood. What can we get rid of that's wood variant right here? We got the dark oak fence. We got this right here. We got the other crafting table. The birch wood. Spruce wood planks. We can put our books away in here because books use wood. Well, they use paper and that comes from wood. So, I mean, yeah, relatively enough. And I think apart from that, we got our sticks. So we're going to need a decent amount of fences and stuff for the styling as well. Get some more fences out from here and sticks. And we'll go down here and make the little jumping area. Now, from what I've read, the lowest that a horse can jump is 1.5 blocks. The highest that a horse can jump is 5.5 blocks. I have never been on a 5.5 block jumping horse. We do have a 5 block jumping horse here. But we do not have a 5.5. And I don't think... I think Allier might have had a 5.5 block jumping horse. I'm not sure. In fact, actually, before we go over here, we're going to need to kill out some cows and get a stack of steak or so. Because we're running pretty low on food. Alright. You can't even hear their moos or anything because there's too many of them. Alright, that should definitely be enough steak right there. In fact, actually, I don't even know if we can pick up all the steak. I think we caught everything. Oh yeah, there's another 8 steak right there. So yeah, we've got a decent amount of steak that's lost us for a while. And we've still got a ton of cows. Love cow farms, honestly. They require a bit of maintenance and a bit of dirty work with your hands to actually keep going and, you know, keep populated. But apart from that, it's really good. So let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blocks away. So I'm thinking right here would be a good spot. So this will have to be 3, 4, 5, and then the slab right on top here. This will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Slab right there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.5. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2.5. 1, 2, and 1.5. So that should be... Alright, this looks good. I'm thinking, could we do something like this, maybe, to make it look a little better? What if we do this? Make a slab right here. Kara's already shaking her head. What if we do that? How does that look? Because I think... It looks weird without some of having a top, you know? No?
That looks fine to me.
I don't know. I want to try that and just see how it looks around the actual area. Because I may be wrong, I may be right if this actually looks good or not. Having a little air gap is definitely a bit weird, but... I think it works for to make it look a bit more gradual. There we go. We can do that right there. And we need one more right here. Perfect. And then we put the other block right there. It definitely looks weird. I don't think I like that, but let's try if we do this, where it just kind of caps off like this here. How does this look? I think I like this better, personally. It looks a bit weird. It definitely does, but I think it looks better because I think it adds more of like a gradual sense. And we could add some, how does this look on the side here with a bit of a lighter contrast? I don't think actually having it this light looks all that good. Now we're going to need to break that one up there. Thankfully that, oh man, that flew far. Then we got the 5 over here. Do you like that? I don't know. We could do the slabs on top here as well. Nah, I think that looks a little bit weird right there. Yeah, definitely, that doesn't look weird. That does look weird. The slabs kind of make it look like it's a bit extended. But apart from that, I think this looks rather good. Do you like this? I kind of do. I think I'm going to stop being lazy and change the styling of the wood. Change the actual wood fences. You know what I would like?
I like the slabs on top of them.
You like the slabs on top of them?
Yeah, it made it look like a nice pattern. Every other one.
I guess so, but I think the thing that that's kind of turning me off from it is the fact that it looks like this is two out, this is one, and this would be two. You know what I mean? I don't know, that looks a little...
Do it every other one.
We'll do it every other one. Yeah, that's what I'm actually meant to do. Yeah, I guess that looks pretty nice. Yeah. So we have our horse. This should be able to jump this block right here. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think this looks good. You like this? I like it. Might need to change up the fences and make them a bit darker. But I think for right now, what we're going to do is excavate out the ground area a little bit here. We're going to need to do the front as well. And we're going to need to get rid of this temporarily. What are we going to make the floor out of? That is another question. Maybe out of wood some more? Maybe, might have to decide that off camera, if I'm being honest. Alright, let's get rid of the dirt entirely underneath here. Hello, zombie. Get rid of this entire thing. We already got the wood platform down right there. Break up this whole grass. I love efficiency 5 when it tears through dirt. It's so freaking good. And, we'll put this back on there for right now, just so we actually keep the redstone. And I think we'll do that for the other blocks as well. Or what we could do is just do the dark oak wood itself right on top here, just for the time being. That's a 3-tick delay. Got the redstone right there. Got the pressure plate right there. And we need to figure out what we're going to make the floor out of. And apart from that, I think we'll be looking good. Yeah, I'm not really sure what I want to do the floor out of. Hello! What would look good compared with this whole area right here? I'm thinking maybe... I don't know. What if we did spruce wood on top? I think the spruce wood actually looks pretty good. It's got a bit of a lighter feel. Along with the wood. Yeah, I think we'll do spruce wood for this build right here, if I can actually... get this done right here. And I think we have a good amount of spruce wood too, so we shouldn't have too much less. Kara did use quite a bit of spruce wood for the undermaking of the casino area. But apart from that, we've got quite a lot. This area right here, definitely gonna need to be changed to spruce wood now. And how much spruce wood do we actually have in our inventory? Oh, tons. Okay, so we can make a crafting table right here. I need to manage my inventory a lot better. Honestly, it's such a downfall of me. Okay, crafting table right there. Let's make some slabs and a ton of them. How much will this give us? This should give us about a stack if we take the leather out right there. Yeah, about a stack of spruce wood slabs. Perfect. And then this can be broken up to right here. Awesome. So we just got to overlay this whole area. We'll put the redstone back down once more. Overlay this whole area with the spruce wood slabs, and I think... Do you like how this is turning out so far?
Yeah.
You say that with a bit of a cringe.
No?
No?
I'm on Twitter. Sorry.
Oh, I gotcha. She's kind of paying attention.
No, I like it. Once you finish it, I'll see. I probably sound so mean in your videos.
Nah. Kara's a beautiful lady. But, I love her. Give me a kiss. Come here.
Oh, God, cut that out.
So if you're wondering why I left this part in, that's basically just to piss Kara off. It's okay. Whenever we do Brunera live streams, there's always a bit of PDA, and it always makes every fangirl in the world scream and Tumblr explode. I know I've used that joke so many times. It's just so original. Okay, so I'm thinking with the slabs right here, this should look good. And I don't know if we'll want a fancy area off or not right now. We could do that maybe later. But, do we actually need the fence? Yeah, just for my own peace of mind. Oh god, that's gonna piss me off. Get that right there. Oh, dang it! Ah! Let me put the... Oh my gosh, this is so hard to build with! Holy crap! I'm just not good at this. Let me put the fence down there. Excellent. Let's please not screw this up any more than we already have. There we go. Yeah, this is definitely only gonna be the horse testing area for this episode right now. But at least we're getting the whole design aspect of it done.
In before creeper.
Now you're starting to sound mean.
Aww.
Nah, it's okay. It's okay. That's happened before. Thankfully, there's no snowmen around the place. But, Yeah, this is how it looks. We go ahead and get the dirt here so it's not too oddly layered. Wish I had grass to kind of service this area off, but for right now, maybe put some glowstone down. Actually,
you have to put dirt.
I need to do what?
You have to put dirt on the other side.
Oh, do I?
Yeah.
I probably missed that. Here we go. Get 30 more. And where was the part that I needed to do?
Right there.
Ah, right here as well. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. All right, perfect. But, that block's a little glitchy too. There we go. Apart from this, the place is pretty much done. I think it looks very clean. We could probably add a bit more of a design to the actual floor later on, but for right now, I think this looks good. Do you like it?
Yeah, and I need lights.
Yeah, now I need lights around it so mobs won't spawn. Let's try and hook up our automatic lighting system to this area. In fact, I'm thinking actually, once we get, and I'm not exaggerating on this, once we get this area done and the automatic fish farm somewhere close here, we'll probably do it like maybe, you could probably actually do it like right here. Or maybe, yeah, we'll find a pretty close area. I want to do something with this area to make it so it's not just this area that's ours. But I think we'll probably add, I swear to God, he thought he took something that we just placed down. Come back here, Enderman. I know it's daytime, but alright, well, apart from that, I think this is pretty much going to do it. Oh, come here! Come here! You ain't on fire yet! Come here, boy! Come here! Where do you... Oh, yeah, you're a lost cause. But anyway, I think that's going to go ahead and wrap up the episode for right now. The next episode, we'll be getting started on the automatic fish farm, and we can name our new bunny. So once again, you guys can leave feedback in the comments on how you think this turned out, if you think there's any ideas of what we could do to make this look a bit better. I don't know why either, but I think that looks rather nice. But anyway, if you guys have any ideas on what you think the new, I don't want to call him the overhead bunny, that's not what he's called, the new bunny should be named, leave a suggestion down in the comments below. I'll read through all of them until a new video gets posted out. That's usually how I do it. I'll read through pretty much every single comment that I get until I post a new one of that series. So yeah, leave your thoughts on how you think that turned out, because I think it looks really good from right here. Especially, it definitely matches the lighting system. Makes the lighting system look not so out of place, you know? And we'll get this fixed up too, so this bunny won't die. And yeah, it's gonna be it. Take care, guys, and have a great one. Ciao!